Dan gaan we naar onze tweede gast van vandaag. Dat is Simon Fletcher, directeur Europe bij UIC. Dat is de International Union of Railways. Good afternoon, Simon. You are part of the conference committee of RailTech Europe, and you will also be hosting the second day. What are your expectations for the conference?
This is quite clearly going to be a RailTech Europe, which is different to any other that I think that we've experienced, because of course the current pandemic means that many people will be unable to be physically present in Utrecht for the event, and that of course is always a shame. But nevertheless, I think with the opportunity of the clever media that we've all become very used to over the last few months, that we should still nevertheless be able to have some kind of event that will be a dynamic, collaborative, and of course a rich exchange of experiences. And in particular, of course, as we move into this, into perhaps a slightly more developed program of evolution for the ERTMS, the rollout of ERTMS, the digitalization of the railway system. All of those issues, of course, are things that we need to still keep the momentum on. But the biggest issue I think that we will find from this is that we all need to learn what this all means now in terms of post-pandemic, the so-called new normal, or maybe that should be the new different. And how we can take that forward together and rekindle the business position and the market position of the railways.
In what way do you think that the pandemic has changed the railway industry, railway sector?
It's quite clear that particularly from the passenger perspective, there have been significantly less passengers travelling by train, simply because most of the government requirements in almost all of the member states around Europe has been to work from home, which is where I'm speaking to you from now, and to ensure that we socially distance from each other. And I think that people therefore were simply not travelling to work, and it means that the way in which we then transport people, particularly in suburban and urban areas, in the future is going to look completely different to what I think we had or what we were experiencing before the pandemic. And in order to get people back onto the trains, we need to make sure that we are reassuring them that it's safe. And that they are in a safe place.
Yeah. So this year is European Year of Rail. It's also dedicated to promote railways as a transport mode. Do you think it will help people to convince to shift to rail?
This has clearly got to be one of the and it falls really nicely if I can dare to say that. That we have this year of rail in 2021, and also the need to be able to dynamise the people into understanding that rail is the railways are a safe place to be, and having the ability, the push, the impetus, the momentum of the European Year of Rail behind us as well. I think it's something that we will be able to utilise to be able to encourage people to come back and use the trains.
And the second day of RailTech Europe is focused on digital rail, and one of the most important topics is ERTMS. And why do you think that topic like that is important?
It's very clear that as part of the drive towards the single European railway area, that wherever possible we are standardising the approach to the way in which we design, construct, operate and maintain the railway system. And it's quite clear that over the years, despite signalling principles being very similar in terms of the spacing of trains to ensure safety, the method by which that spacing has been developed has differed from country to country. In order to be able to provide a seamless passage of trains across Europe, it's important not only to have a standardised signalling system, but also standardised energy supply and so on. So ERTMS is a piece in the jigsaw. It's an important piece in the jigsaw, and it's something which I think we will be able to look forward to as being a significant component in driving forward the interoperable railway of tomorrow.
A recent report of the European Commission said that the rollout of ERTMS is lagging behind. In April 2020, installation of the system only reached about 78% of the target for 2019. How can you explain this?
Quite clearly, whenever programs are rolled out, there is always the temptation to be slightly overambitious. And I would suggest that if the figure had been 28%, then we really would have a problem. But 78% is actually, I would suggest, probably quite an element of a success story. It's not, of course, the 100% that was being identified. But certainly, I think the rollout is a complex thing to do. You clearly need to ensure that you have got the ability to close railway lines and to fit equipment into rolling stock and so on. And despite the fact, dare I say, that throughout the pandemic that there have been less people in the trains have nevertheless been running. And so therefore, it is still something which needs to be factored in order to be able to fit the equipment. You need to have the safe access to the infrastructure of the rolling stock for the staff to be able to do that. And so I think there is still the momentum. We encourage the commissioner for the fitment of ERTMS, Matthias Reiter, in his work. And I think that we have the opportunity now to be able to even more during this year of rail and with the added momentum, the added impetus to be able to drive forward the program.
And what can be done to accelerate this rollout?
In order to accelerate the rollout, of course, we of course need to ensure that there is first of all the right amount of equipment has to be made available, and we have to make sure that there is that the, as I said just now, the closure of the access to the network, the access to the infrastructure is important, and the accessibility of the rolling stock. If you're going to run trains, you need to be able to have the locomotives, the rolling stock available to be able to do that. If you withdraw them in order to fit the equipment, then of course you have a problem with the service provision. So there are an element number of elements that need to be taken into account, I think, in order to be able to do that.
Yeah. What are your expectation of new technologies such as automatic train operation?
Automatic train operation, of course, as you were talking just now about the second day of RailTech, and that is going to be very much a question of the digitalization aspects of the program. And certainly automation of the railway is something which is going to be significant game changer in the way in which the railways are A, perceived, but B, operated. It will, to a certain extent, automise an awful lot of the things that we currently take that we use people to do. But at the same time, it will automate a number of tasks, particularly in the driving cab. So the driver's life will become a little easier because there will be elements of automation, or better elements of automation, creeping in. Some of the equipment that maybe we require in the driving cab today can be removed, because it will no longer be required, because automation will have helped to improve the safety of the railway and to make the driver's job not only less stressful, but also make the driver a more efficient component in the important aspect of operating the railway system safely and on time.
Do you also think that it will help the railway sector to be more competitive?
I think any form of improvement, any form of evolution that in fact is helping the railways to be more efficient will of course have a knock-on in the way in which we can maximise the resources that we have, that we minimise the risks that we have in the railway system, and therefore reduce the cost factor that we have. And so from that point of view, it will inevitably mean that we can be more competitive, because it means that we can offer the opportunity for people, and indeed for goods as well on trains, to be moved from A to B, which is the principal role of the railway system, in a much more competitive manner.
Thank you very much, Simon Fletcher from UIC. I look forward to see you at the conference.
Yeah, no, look, hopefully we'll have a really, really good session on digitalization on the 31st of March.
Yes, looking forward to it.
Thank you.